Just coming up to 10 minutes past seven, and our top story in the programme today, romance fraud is on the rise in Sussex. I'll be talking to Sussex Police in an hour's time to find out how they can fight this crime and also what we can do to protect ourselves. But first of all, have a listen to this. This is Hazel Wilkins from Rusper, who lost her life savings to a man she met online. She told me how the relationship came about.
Well, it was my girls that sort of, you know, said, why don't you try, Mum? You know, and I thought, oh, I'll give it a go. No, I just went on the dating site and started chatting, and he came on.
Okay, and it went okay for a while, did it?
Oh, yeah, we got on really well. We had similar sense of humour. I've got to say, he was the most cleverest person I've ever met, and I can't see men in the same way.
And did this move on from the dating website into a relationship where you met up?
Oh, yeah, he lived up north, and I lived obviously in Crawley. And he came down to see me, and I had a five-bedroom house. And, yeah, he came down to see me. He said, can I stay? You know, I've got this work to do. I work from home. He's got this big company. So I left him at my home, and I went off to Gatwick and did my job.
When did it go wrong?
Oh, he proposed to me, and I accepted. So we just carried on dating, and he took me on a cruise and all this, that and the other. Little did I know, he was going through all my private things, got my bank account number and got loads of other things out of my drawer. And that's how it all happened. He said he's got to go up north. So he packed his bags and left, and left me with nothing in my bank.
What was the total amount, do you think?
Oh, it was probably 20,000, something like that.
So there's the financial hurt of that, you know, and that's always going to be difficult money to come across. But actually, it's the personal slight on you, and the fact that you didn't notice it, and the fact that he played you and was in your own home doing those things behind your back. How much does that still hurt?
Every day. Sorry. Every day. Oh, I don't see men in the same way anymore. No disrespect. But I can't have another man in my life. I can't. He ruined my life and everything that I'd worked hard for, and I lost it all because of him.
And you said before your daughters were encouraging you to, you know, maybe try and meet somebody, you know, have somebody that can go to the cinema with or whatever. And what's their reaction to this been? Has it been for them?
It has got to them, obviously, because I'm not the same person. And I don't like being like that to my girls. I can't trust anybody anymore.
What would you say the warning signs might be? What sort of things should we look out for?
If you don't know that person, just don't let them, you know, run wild in your house. Sort of, you know, he had the run of my house while I was working at Gatwick. He was just, you know, looking through everything. That's where he got my bank details from. I didn't give them to him because he was supposed to have loads of money.
I'm so sorry you went through that, Hazel, and it obviously still hurts you very much now. But, you know, by speaking about it, that makes, perhaps that flags it in somebody else's head and they won't get caught like you did. So I'm sorry for what happened to you, but hopefully you'll help somebody else.
Well, I'm more than willing to help. I really am, because I don't want people to go through what I'm going through, still going through. Just be really, really careful.
That's Hazel Wilkins from Rusper speaking to me earlier. Let's bring into this conversation now David Clarke, who's chair of the charity The Fraud Advisory Panel and used to head the City of London Police Fraud Squad. David, morning to you.
Good morning.
And you've dealt with all sorts, I'm sure, over the years. But how do you feel when you still hear people like Hazel telling her story?
Oh, I just feel devastated. Everybody in life has the right to find love and friendship. And you know, romance fraud, it's the most treacherous, devious, cunning of all the frauds. It's despicable. And can I just say, you know, well done to Hazel. What an inspiration and honesty there. Thinking about helping others so that others don't fall for that. Very courageous, done exactly the right thing. And getting it reported, a very, very brave lady and an inspiration to many others who were perhaps frightened and embarrassed to report. So well done, Hazel.
Yes, and I can understand that, because it's, you know, when the scales fall from your eyes, it perhaps looks so obvious. But, you know, he was playing a long game with her over, you know, 18 months or so. So, David, with an increase in online dating, do you think that frauds like this will continue to be more common?
Yeah, I do, tragically. And this is why, and I'm very pleased with the BBC that you get this message out to people. Everybody, we must be telling our friends about this. It's one of those horrible crimes. Sussex Police, probably tell you later, they've seen a big increase. In the Fraud Advisory Panel, we set up a COVID-19 fraud watch right back at the start of lockdown. And we identified that, you know, things like romance fraud, people at home are going to be more vulnerable. And we'll also see it's the fraudsters in their cunning grooming. They're looking for people who have a slight vulnerability, and being at home like this, they'd be a people to target. So we've really got to be extra careful. And if you're online, nothing wrong with these dating websites. One of my daughters down in Sussex there, she met her husband today. We've got lovely grandchildren. Sadly, we can't see with the lockdown.
Yeah.
But, you know, stay on those websites. Don't be drawn off them. And do your research on these people. And I often say, you know, when people say they work in certain jobs, have a look online. There's nothing wrong with that. Look on Facebook, look on LinkedIn, you know, look at their social media. Do a little bit of research on them, turn detective, you know, because they'll be very cunning, the bad ones. And in love, it, you know, I'm sure none of us mind somebody checking out to see who we are. We've done that in the previous world. And also talk to a friend. Many of these, I had helped a lady called Elizabeth a couple of years ago. I think she had the largest loss, 1.6 million she gave, 1.6 million. And it came about, like so often, by people talking to a friend. So, you know, out there, talk to your friends, encourage them, talk to your family and others, and ask about them. But also think cautiously. Have you done a little bit of checking on this person? And there are things you can do, as I say, looking online at them.
What more can be done to tackle this and put off the potential perpetrators, do you think?
Well, these people, I say, are amongst the most cunning, horrible fraudsters that you'll come across. They'll go after the most vulnerable people. They'll lead them up. They use hypnotic techniques. If you look at some of these cases, they'll hypnotise. They'll give rewards. Horrible. What we should be doing is look out for each other, be cautious, do these checks. What we're also doing from the Fraud Advisory Panel, and it'll be starting soon, I'm bringing a small group together. There's a lot more also that can be done on social media. We've got sites where people will put, like on a LinkedIn and Facebook, they can create fake accounts for themselves, these fraudsters, and that gives them the air of respectability. We'd like the social media channels to take more action in bringing those sites down so that they don't hide behind this. But that's for a little bit in the future. For now, what Hazel's done, don't be embarrassed to talk about it. Help, and don't be frightened to report. Action Fraud is the police hotline, actionfraud.police.uk. It has a free number there. You ring pretty much any hours. You can make your report online. But really, not being embarrassed to report. What Hazel and the other victims have done, and men as well, I think that was pointed out, lots of men fall for this, and they're very embarrassed to report it, because blokes, we don't think we'll fall for this. We can, but report it, please. You're helping others by doing it, even if we can't get the money back.
David, thank you very much indeed for your time this morning. David Clarke there, Chair of the charity, the Fraud Advisory Panel.